He worked on it 5 minutes.
5 to 10. 10 was the max.
Welcome to the Foul Mouth Al Show. We're here this week. We have a handful of new people. Ian, the producer's over at his desk today. Let's give Ian a hand, guys. He showed up. He was damn near on time today.
Very good.
He has got our notes here for me and my co-host, Miss Ashley Smack, is here with me today. Let's give Ashley a big hand. Ashley worked hard this week on some stuff for the show. What do you got for us today, Miss Ashley? We're going to do a little bit later.
I'll be doing the news later. I've got a little research from the band. My favorite songs of theirs.
Oh, you like My Name is Drew? They're coming in today?
Yeah, I want to know where they came up with that name. Because none of them are named Drew.
Yeah, I thought the same.
So, I want to know about Drew.
They're pretty awesome, though. I've been listening to their music all week.
Their music's good.
They're going to be playing at Mojo this week, so... I don't think Miss Renee from Mojo is going to be able to make it. She was supposed to be here, but I think she got arrested or something, but I don't know. We'll find out. I'm sure I'll get a text from her here in a little while. So, see, Ian's got some stuff ready for you there, Miss Ashley. How's that looking? How's Ian doing? I see he's got your agenda for tonight going.
This agenda's pretty intense here, Al. It's fully loaded. Looks like my 8-year-old wrote it, actually.
Ian. Look at this handwriting. What is this deal, Ian? Come here, Ian.
And like Squiggy Squig.
Come over
out,
here, Ian.
He wrote in pencil, but didn't even bother to erase. He just scribbled through.
This is Ian's favorite part of the show.
Can I grab this? Use the eraser, Ian.
He works hard all week doing nothing so that we can bust his balls. This is Ian's favorite part
of
the show.
This is Ian's production. Hold that up so I can take the picture.
I like your shirt tonight.
So, Ian, you've been... I gave you a couple tasks this week.
Yeah.
You got your spreadsheet for Excel here with you today? Huh?
He's unprepared.
You got to speak a little louder. Hold on, this mic's holding me over here. All right, go ahead. You got your Excel sheet with you today?
I do not.
Why not?
I did start it, I didn't finish. So I have all my stuff in my notebook.
So what time were you getting up? What was your average wake-up time this week?
Wait, let's bet. Come on.
Huh?
This could have been a game.
I've called him almost every day this week, so I know the answer to this question.
You woke him up every day.
I just want to see what his interpretation, because I know what time Ian gets up every day.
Noon?
I just want to see what time Ian thinks he gets up.
Average 11 o'clock.
So you're being sort of realistic, okay? So that's pretty close, 11 o'clock. Today was up about 9:30.
I don't even know the last time I slept till 11.
I know.
At 11 o'clock, I was still partying.
What's he, 22?
Mm-hmm. Remember what we used to do?
No.
I'm 20. No,
we
I'm
still made 22. It up earlier.
Yeah, you guys stay up later than he does now, and you're still up earlier.
Yeah.
I go to bed midnight. I get up at 4:30.
So, Ian, what else have you done this week to help further the progress of the Foul Mouth Al Show?
What have you contributed to society?
I posted a few Craigslist ads, posted a few Facebook statuses.
Have you gotten any response from your ads?
Yes, for photographers, a few bands, but mostly rappers. I did a few Facebook statuses, got a few likes, people that want to show their mixtape off, and then I have a complaint. Parties, just telling people about.
So Ian directed me to a band. He found a band called the Grassheads. They write about smoking pot and they rap about smoking pot, and their music's pretty good and they're sticking to their true thing, so I said go ahead, book them. Did you book the Grassheads?
I discovered them. I didn't.
He discovered them.
Hey, yeah.
So he sent something to him, and then the guy texted you back. He said what?
He's texting me back. I was like, yo, listen, here are the dates that are free. I was like, get back to me, man, let me know what you know, what day would be good for you. And he texted me back, swag, and I wasn't sure.
Swag?
I wasn't sure whether that was like a swag, like, all right, y'all, look into it, or yo, we're there, you know what I mean? We want to be there. So I was just waiting a few days for it, and then.
You were what?
I was going to wait a few days before I was like.
What was the purpose of waiting a few days?
I don't know, I just didn't want to bug him, man.
Your job, here, let me explain. Your job is to bug these motherfuckers. Bug them. You're doing them a favor. Do they want to promote themselves?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're doing them a favor. Who do they want to produce and promote them? Do they want some guy that's going to wait and see if they're going to get him back? Because when the club owner calls, okay, and says, you say, hey, I got this great band, I want to book them in your club, and he says, swag, what are you going to do, wait a few days?
No, honestly, man, it was just like, it was, I just added the dude as a friend, so I can see him, like, yo, like, waiting a little bit, I'm not going to be up his butt, like, yo, yo, dude.
Now, what you need to say is, you're like, look, we've got, we're booking within the next 3 months. Yeah, we're all booked up for 2 months. Somebody
your
just
friend Gusto,
next week. Do you want it?
Yeah. That you referred.
It's going to be till November.
Tell him you got 2 days, man.
Your friend Gusto that you referred, I like Gusto. I like Gusto. His music's awesome. I play it in the, and he told me to play it, so I'm playing it in the shows. The people that listen, they know Gusto's music. They want to hear Gusto in here.
Right.
Have you booked Gusto yet? Every time you try to put Gusto on the schedule, what happens?
He said he'll get back to me too.
Yeah, and you're waiting for him to get back to you. You got to get on him and get him on the schedule. Every time you say a certain date with Gusto, though, you turn around, I filled the date. Well, guess what? I filled the date. The Grassheads are going to be here on the 30th.
Okay.
So they're waiting for you to get back to them still. So you got to get on this shit, man. I know you're young. and dumb, and he's a blonde. And the pay around here ain't so good. You know, you don't get paid, and we're going to pick on you. And we're still going to expect you to do some work. Okay, so next week when you come in here, okay, as my producer, you've got to have that schedule for September filled. I filled the schedule for October. It's full. By the 10th of the month, it has to be full for the following month. That's the rule.
Make it right.
You better watch it, his buddy's watching his back.
Should make it right. I'll get back to you 100 times.
Huh? Yep. Yep. I want that by 7:30 segment. I want you to write 100 times. I will get back to people. I will get back to people.
With one pencil.
With give me a pen and I'll do it. I can get right with it.
One pen.
I'll give you. You got to do it with a pencil.
Erase it. Don't scribble through.
Oh, then it's got to be a pencil.
You got it. Yeah. If you don't like the pencil, it's got to be done with a pencil. Right. That's all there is to it.
Sharpen it with your teeth.
We want it in braille.
All right.
I want to know why you never liked Ashley on Facebook. I sent you a message.
I'm really on Facebook. Sorry. I'm sorry. I mean, I get the notifications.
Don't you think our producer should like me?
He ought to.
He doesn't. He doesn't like me.
What the fuck's wrong with you?
I don't know. I sent him a message. It doesn't look good. My producer does not like me.
Sounds like love.
He's afraid.
I like it right now.
Let me get on my iPad and like it.
You better get on there and you better like. You better find a million bands and you better like them.
What do you want to do? You want to write 100 times? Or you want to write a million bands?
I want you to do it all. What are you going to get done?
Let's make a new paragraph. I will get back to a million bands immediately and go to Facebook and like them.
Yeah, 100 times of that.
Or find 100 or book.
Or have the dance or have September filled by 7:30.
So have September filled or right 100 times.
And if you do both, then we'll let you out of playing their game tonight.
Or you get the Ash Mac or 6,000.
Yeah, but maybe he's doing it so we're leaving alone.
Yeah.
See?
Well, it ain't going to work.
All right.
So
I'm just kidding. I'll do it.
We're pretty demanded down here, man.
We need it.
Pretty demanded.
Something's up.
All right, well, you better go find some bands, get some bands booked. And quick, give me two Aerosmith songs.
Aerosmith?
Yep.
I thought it was
that was last week.
Aerosmith.
I'll give you a minute to think about it. Right over here today with us is Chef Bones, that we're going to talk to about Inside the Metal Kitchen, his cookbook, Chef Bones. And we're here with a young lady. What's your name? Come on up to the mic and tell us your name.
Mahala
Mookie, and Mookie is here tonight talking to us about possibly doing some editing and maybe working with the show, and she's sitting in with this first segment. And we're also here with Mr. Salt and Relish or whatever the hell.
It's salt for short, please.
It's salt. Yeah, it's short. That's
salt
what we hear.
I really don't like relish.
You don't like relish?
I don't like relish either.
Squiggy.
Well, look, that's salt and that's relish. That's salt and relish.
Salt, he's squig.
Salt and pepper.
Or Phoebus and Ferb, whatever you want to call it.
Phineas and Ferb.
How about Schmooz and Schmutz?
Yeah, how about Schmoozers?
Huh?
Schmooz. Schmoozers.
Give me the definition.
Oh, Lord. Don't make me guzzle a beer on you. Don't make me guzzle
a
beer.
So we're here with Salt and Squig. Now back to fucking education over here. What's going on, man?
I usually could look something up, but I didn't cheat. Oh, I don't know.
You could Google on your.
You can't come up with any Aerosmith.
I usually do that. I'm trying to really.
So last week you couldn't remember any Lynyrd Skynyrd songs. This week you don't know any Aerosmith.
We just whistled one. Run DMC.
Yeah, there was one with Run DMC.
Yeah.
What was it?
I don't know. I remember the music video. I can't even think of the. I can see here the lyrics right now. I can't even.
You sure this isn't an act? Come on now.
Just say it like 50 times.
This is our producer.
Our executive producer.
That's why his name plays.
He's a music producer. He books rap and hip hop and rock and roll artists, but he doesn't know the origin of where this came from. So.
I got Willie Nelson.
Yeah, you know any Willie Nelson songs?
I heard of Willie Nelson.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, you're gonna be fucked when Ronnie gets here with his game tonight.
Yeah, and guess what it is? Willie you get Nelson stabbed tonight.
Yeah, we had to
in your tongue, and then we pierced it.
Mookie's rolling. She's walking, running out the door
Mookie's
right
gone.
Now.
She lasted 10 minutes.
Our producer's holding her back.
He's thinking, "Let me go over here, and start writing this shit."
Come back, Mookie.
Because if you do both, you ain't got to play.
Yep, we're gonna during our at the end of the in between segments, we're gonna pick something from the Box of Doom, and the loser will have to do something horrible again.
The Box of Doom.
Like last week. Yeah, we got to talk about that. We got to make the Box of Doom up. We haven't made it up.
That sounds fun.
Ian, what are you doing? Where's the Box of Doom? Come on, you're the producer.
We just saw that today. You kind
of. I thought of that today. Usually I think of shit today. I get it done today. Get it done.
Down
here below the canal, son. The rule was get her done.
Look,
get her done.
Boxes right there. You're good. Just figure out what the Doom is.
Look, Mookie's
be.
From Dover, but she goes to New York. She's from New York. She knows the difference between below and above the canal.
They give you a sticker LSD, huh?
Yep. Lower, slower, Delaware.
Lower, slower, Delaware. Whoa.
We get her done. There's no trying. Just go do it.
Right.
Go book something. Go book something. Create a Box of Doom.
What about Gusta? I mean, I can still hit him up. But.
Hit him up. Call him. I don't want no text, man. You're not allowed to text our people anymore.
I don't know.
It looks bad when you send a text and then forget about them.
Yeah.
And don't understand the language. Swag means call me back now, motherfucker. That's what swag means from now on.
Yeah, I did
want
to ask.
It means sweet. Something today.
I hear it used a lot. It's on the.
That's right.
Or it fits in, I guess.
Back to your office over there and get some damn work done.
Hey, you know.
Book some man using a computer.
I think
I forgot I brought
show.
Presents.
You can keep them around.
You got presents.
Couple presents. Just fun stuff.
Ashley's got fun presents. Go ahead. Break them
I was at the store and I saw these.
Ian, you can use the computer,
look,
whatever you need to do,
some of
buddy.
Some will appreciate it. Some not. I know you're gonna love this, Al. Remember these?
Hey, let's hope that shirt was a.
Oh yeah.
Gag
yep.
For us tonight.
Squidgy.
Oh, and this has gum in it too. Wacky package stickers.
This is like totally old school
stuff
right
here. Cabbage Patch Pale Kids?
It's kind of like that, but these were like wacky packages.
What was it?
Yes.
Anyway,
yes.
So open up and see what your wacky package is.
Yeah,
I remember this stuff.
You remember this?
All different.
Look, I got cuts, razor thin potato chips.
Bruises first, break.
Fish
break.
Deal them out. Everybody gets one. Give one to Mike.
Sea germs, ginger algae.
Oh, Lord.
And.
I got a big piece of stale gum.
Afraid. No, they put the gum in plastic now. You see that? Before, this is fresh gum.
Remember, these never come off the fridge.
Oh,
that's funny.
Thank you.
I got Play-Dohs.
That's
so are
good
we reading
right
what
there?
Conk out clay?
Yeah.
You got to pass. I passed that one over to him.
He's got what's three of them.
I got Head and Smolders. Honey Tunes.
I got Old Slice.
This is funny stuff.
Hey, I think this was one of those
factors.
Play Doh's.
What?
She said you can have that.
Now we're all going to be chewing gum.
The ooze sticks a real snooze.
Why, you smelling too?
What am I thinking?
These are funny.
Yeah,
cuts, potato chips, ginger algae soda.
Honey Tune.
That stuff's disgusting.
And bruises this break.
Let me see your stickers. I got to take a picture.
We're sick people thinking that this is humorous. And then we give this to our kids.
Honey Tune, remember this?
She gave me this one.
Schmolders.
What's that about?
Old Slice, crusty deodorant stink.
Hey, I'm smelling too.
She said.
Guess what? It's his feet.
No, it's called working 10 hours and coming here.
Straight from Salt's armpit.
Straight from work.
Remember one show I said he smelled like salt?
Mookie said, I'm going to give this stinky looking thing to the guy next to me. This fat guy is stinky.
What's up with that?
She should have took off the sticker.
I just sprayed some. Well, we can't use brand names on the radio here, right? What's that the one commercial where all
you can. Maybe they'll pick us up as a sponsor. We need sponsorships.
Axel. I put a little axle.
Axe.
Archie Bunker. Axe.
It's deodorant and body
it's missing
spray.
It. Well, it's just missing it.
And did your wife attack you after that?
I don't know.
Your hot Italian wife?
Ride down the road.
Salt has a beautiful wife and a beautiful family. Yeah. My friend Dan peeks out the window at your
you
wife while
off,
she's
Salt?
In the pool. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know
so
Dan.
I'm
going
to have to watch that guy a little
yeah,
closer.
Yeah, that's right.
Show him the pictures.
You ain't got to worry about that. It's Mark you got to watch out for. He's her emotional friend.
I'll take him out.
It's those guys.
That's what he says.
We work together. We talk about this guy 8 hours a day.
See? Damn. You got to watch out for that shit. Ooh. Mark ain't fooling around.
She got a couch in her office.
I hope my heart holds out.
Why? It's
because
hurts from being shocked.
You know, when you die, you would hate to have the guy carrying your casket out and put you in the ground, end up raising your kids the next one. You know, you
want someone's got to comfort the grieving wife.
Yeah.
You know?
Huh?
You never know.
That's where you pick up women
would
and
probably
men.
Do that.
Funerals.
No, I never would.
Squiggly.
I got my last date came from a funeral.
After the 10th time of her begging, I'd say, all right.
I wouldn't.
It'd
well,
be
look,
like Aflac and all every other short.
Last week when Salt came in, Mark had some things to say, and Salt was a little bit upset
that
about it.
That was supposed to go with third segment. Ian's notes.
No. Well,
we better stick with the schedule.
It's not. It's no. That's no.
Because
I don't
Ian?
Need to know nothing what he says.
I apologize to Mike Sautarelli. I love him.
Hey, my name
he is my
name
best
Sautarelli.
Friend. His
I'm
name
Salt.
Is.
Salt here on the radio.
And I will give him a kiss right now. On, and
no, you're not.
Proven. Yes, I am.
Go ahead, kiss him. Ian, where's your pictures?
Now give me a beer, bitch.
No,
did you just stick your tongue in his ear? I think you did.
Do it again.
We'll
do it again.
Fun.
Come on, we need some.
The people want some.
Yes,
please. The people want their
that's so beautiful.
Yes.
Oh, wait. No, I got it on
it
the
was
separation.
Salty. Let me take a drink of beer.
You got to hold it until, yeah, you got to hold
yeah,
it until Ashley.
Hey, I can't kiss him again.
Come on.
If we're going to make it funny, let's do it like this.
Yeah, there you go.
It's like you shake it more than once, you're playing with it.
All right.
I want the tongue.
Did I move too much? Yeah. Here, I'll stick my tongue out on it. I'm going to roll my tongue. All right. Your
nah, that's okay. All
right. So Squig,
before he starts dry humping him, stop.
Squig is offering an apology here, Salt.
What, you got some money?
I apologize, kid.
He's not, or what, he asked for rockin' reparations or something?
You what?
What do you want, money?
Yeah, the money's always good.
What's it worth to you?
I don't know. I like the cars that have money in them.
I feel so bad for stereotyping him as a fat person.
Stereotyping?
He's just overweight.
I'm just husky, big bone.
If he actually gets reparations, you may owe money to all fat people across the country.
Yeah.
You're saying Mike's fat too?
You might see me on one of those.
No, that's the market.
Salt,
that
when you fly, do you have to pay for two airline tickets?
No.
Okay,
no,
then you're not that big.
Not that big. Why do I look it?
Well, look, he's apologizing. Are you accepting?
Well, it's good for apology this weekend.
All right.
Next weekend, it'll be a totally different thing.
Oh, yeah.
What, are you going to be upset and crying about it again?
No,
yeah.
I don't cry.
Please don't tease me.
You don't think he's sincere? Do you think?
You see me dance out.
Hey, you want to take
like
pictures
MMR,
on my text? You hurt my feelings.
Do you think he's sincere, or do you think he's going to renege on that? And
I talked to him at home personally.
Yeah, it looked a little serious. When he did, so.
I had an Indian tear go like this.
Well, we'll
one
see.
Indian tear.
We'll see. His Ricardo's like supposed to stop
all
by.
Right,
Ricky Ricardo's stopping by, so we'll really see. Have the judge come
all
out
right,
when
well.
He comes here.
We'll
see. Me and Rich always team up on you, so
we'll
that's
see.
Fucked up.
I gotta quit chewing this damn gum.
I take
I was
my apology
say, your
back.
Lip smacking over there, Al.
I can hear it too with these headphones.
Albert,
you're gonna
I take
be
my
editing this
back.
Later, going God, what was I doing?
What, eating gum?
Yeah, you ain't.
And that's stale, right?
No, it's delicious.
No, they
our whole segment
now.
Has to be recorded again now. We'll get
remember
back
you
to
get
it
out, you could snap this like a communion wafer.
We need to talk to Chip.
Well, now that you guys have kissed and made up.
No, he kissed me. I didn't make up.
You made out.
He just wanted to get it a little. He likes the salt taste on his lips.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You didn't see his hand under the table. Stupid lip of the table, you nasty bitch.
Ian, what's the name of the photographer that's coming next week?
Can we get a
no,
portrait
no,
together?
Michelle. I don't know. Michelle.
Michelle Lee Photography, is that right?
Yeah.
Can we get a portrait together?
Is that right? Like
it, yeah.
I need the young lady's name for sure if we're gonna. Yeah. I'm gonna promote her here tonight. That's why I need it on my sheet. Remember?
Well, that was a little bit too much work for him.
Yes.
I don't think there's enough room.
Mark agreed to Speedos, us two.
Rich.
You guys are going to wear Speedos?
Yeah, to celebrate New York's gay marriage. We're going to get in Speedos and take a family portrait together, Derek.
That'd be great. We need like somebody dressed up as Elvis to marry him.
But look, Albert, we're going to have boners
right now.
You can do it right now.
You can do it right now. You got some Speedos.
Well, you got no Speedos.
So you guys are going to wear Speedos next week for the...
No, Mike is with a boner.
And if he does, I will.
Mike's going to have Speedos with a
boner.
But his has to be a G-string.
Oh, gross. I think I'm going
to
get sick.
As long as it isn't green, okay? We're gonna
you
be
don't
doing,
even have to be a lesbian to say that's nasty.
We're going
to
be doing pictures in front of the green screen, so don't wear anything green if you're here next
week.
What
are we wearing? What are you wearing?
I don't know. I'll probably wear this. This is my good T-shirt.
Really?
He said he jumped a bunch of weight, so he should be able to get in a portrait.
I absolutely have to get some new clothes.
Ian did some work.
Look, Ian has produced a name. Yes, Ian.
All right.
A name.
See, work pays off. Keep working over there. Get Gusto on the schedule. I want him here the first week of September. That would be great. Michelle Wallace from Michelle Lee Photography. She is a photographer who will be here next week, August 9th, with Awake at Last. The following week, August 16th, we're going to be here with rapper Reese. Look him up on Facebook. He's a lot of fun. Mark apologized to Salt and just slapped him upside his head on August 23rd. Yeah, that's a love tap, folks. These guys love each other. You should see
that
it.
That was what's that called?
We're gonna starting to fall in love with you too.
We're gonna have a wrestling event. You guys could do that. You guys could wrestle out at Rich's house. All right.
So we've done that before in drunken rages.
Yes, you have. We've never organized it though, and have it on pay per view.
That's why we need you.
That's what we're collecting all our video here, Mookie, for pay-per-view.
Could be a big
one. Yeah, well, we use this for radio and promote stuff. We can take the funnier clips and collect them and maybe have a pay-per-view someday. So we got some stuff planned up.
We got bloopers.
August 23rd, the band will be the Tweed. They are coming in here. They are awesome. You got to check them out. And then August 30th, we're having a band called the Grassheads. Check them out on Facebook. And they're going to be joined later on in the evening with Altar of Dagon. So it's going to be an interesting night. We're going to have rappers in early on, and they're going to be no doubtly using some herbal supplements of some sort. And
that's
then
right. They bring in samples?
Altar of Dagon's going to be coming later on, and they're a thrash heavy metal band. I'm going to try to get the rappers to spit some lyrics over top of...
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
The guitar, I got a guitar right there. If we can get a heavy metal guy, listen, on acoustic, tear it up some shit, just do the same motifs over and over, and then get some rappers to put something on that. We'll record it right here on the Foul Mouth Owl Show. That'll be pretty cool.
Sweet.
So. Hit the charts.
All right, well, we got some listener email to go through that we got here this week. So what the hell did I do with the email? This ain't it. And where the hell's the email at? Where's the listener mail at for this week? You got it together yet?
No.
Never mind, Ian. God. Never mind. I got it right here, Ian. Never mind. Keep hammering over there. You look too relaxed, buddy. You better get somebody on the phone.
He's got his hand on his chin. You
better have some Aerosmith answers when I get back over here later. And 100 times, you better write some shit down.
He's sleeping.
Now, where the hell's Squig at? We got this stuff for Squig, and he's not even here. All right? Have you guys listened to My Name is Drew?
No, I haven't.
They're awesome, dude. They got a song called Relax that I really like.
Yeah, I like that one, too.
Yeah, me too.
And that's my favorite. I've been listening to them all week.
Flashlights in a Bright Room.
Flashlights in a Bright Room.
I'd like to know the story behind that.
Well, I'm looking forward to it.
Well, they've got some cool things that they've sent us here that we're going to be talking about. They played with Weezer.
Weezer?
Did they?
Yeah, we're going to talk to them. These guys are no joke. This is a real professional band coming in tonight. They're young kids, but they're professional.
As opposed to
the guys that were here last week and didn't have anything else to do, so they showed up because we called
them
the day before. No, we love those guys. And by the way, okay, we got some news. I want to update you guys on the Last Valorians, okay? They were here last week. The Last Valorians, there's been some updates. John, the guy that was not here, he's no longer considered a retard. They think he's a great guy, and they want to apologize for telling us that he was a retard. Apparently, John kicked their fucking ass, I guess. I don't know. But they all seemed pretty scared when we talked to him last night. And the other thing, Dustin, who was going with a girl that he banged on top of the Waffle House, is now single. So all the young ladies out there that would like to get banged on top of the Waffle House or Smyrna Diner, he's ready to upgrade to the Smyrna Diner.
I'll meet you on the Waffle House, baby.
Ashley is.
That means she's available too, right?
Ashley is available. She's cougaring it. Oh, are you interested in her? I see you
maple
checking
syrup.
Her out there. Mookie, come on, Mookie.
Huh? Mookie wants to get schmookie.
Mookie wants to be schmoozy.
Waffle House, that's pretty.
You know, I thought about calling the show just to ask for John because we didn't get to meet.
Oh, John wasn't there last night either, but
he's
those
still
guys.
Fishing?
I don't know, but he put the fear of God in the rest of the guys in the band. They were not calling him a retard, and they were apologizing.
Oh,
so
that's sweet, guys. Very sweet.
John is a guitar player for the Last Valorians that was not here with us last week. He was the only guy in the band that wasn't here. So they kind of picked on him. And
fishing.
Apparently, he beat their fucking ass and put him in line. Because last night they came to the Dungeon of Man Love show.
Even Colton with the big guns.
And Colton was not fucking around. He made it clear that, you know, John is the shit.
Well, hopefully we'll meet him on your...
Hey, those guys rock. Don't think... I am joking around saying that they're the last minute band. Had nothing. These guys are new. They just got their shit together. If you listen to their music, go to... find them. Look at them on Facebook. The Last Valorians. V-A-L-O-R-I-A-N-S. They are heavy metal. They push the edge with it. They do go into the screaming, okay, which they have a name for that. I don't know exactly what they call that, but they are pushing the edge. He does scream sometimes, but musically those guys are talented, and they got their shit together. So if they weren't, they wouldn't be on the Foul Mouth Owl show.
That's a nice deep voice.
What's that
too,
called, Bistro?
What's that?
That type of screaming and singing and heavy metal.
Screamo?
Satan's Holler.
Yeah.
That's what it's called, Satan's Holler?
Something.
Yes. Bistro should know.
Well, Dustin was here last week, and he was telling us about his escapades on top of the Waffle House, and then he happened to mention that he was still with the girl that he had the escapade with on the Waffle House, and she heard that on the show and decided that it was over.
He forgot to knock on wood.
So thanks to the Foul Mouth Owl Show, we are ruining relationships everywhere.
Yep.
We're bringing more single rock and roll guys back to the market.
Mission accomplished.
For all you young ladies and the cougars like Miss Ashley out there who's looking for these young guys. Don't go home horny, young guys.
Hey, I did check out her Facebook.
Out there.
Did you like me on Facebook? You did not like me.
Very
salt.
Interesting.
We didn't. Yeah, she didn't. Said she didn't see your like on there. You didn't click like.
Did you shy away? Don't shy away.
You shied away.
I'm in the middle of a bathroom break at work.
Wow. There's more pictures.
Taking shit and looking at your Facebook.
I'm glad you Googled me while you're taking a dump.
No.
I feel special.
Mark, he was whacking it, is what he's saying.
That's why he's got that big cover on.
But if you click like, you'll get Ashley's naked pictures.
That's girl asked about, so that was salt.
Where?
If you click like on her Facebook page, you'll get her naked
picture.
Yeah.
Thumbs up.
Okay, yeah. Well, I have to.
If you click on that, you get a hand job.
Mookie's checking you out, Ashley. Look at her.
Hey, go right now to Facebook and hit it. Hey, I should hit like now.
If
that's
I had service
got it.
In here.
Hold on. What'd you say?
I said I might have to Google her if I had service in here.
Huh? You gotta have service.
Not down the basement. Wait,
oh, if you're on Verizon, you probably won't have service.
Yeah, no. We're cut off down here.
Can't hear me now.
This is like being
so
on
you like girls?
Planet.
You date girls? You date guys? You married?
Nope, I'm not married. I do date girls. I don't date guys.
You don't date guys? Just girls?
Yep.
Okay, congratulations.
Right.
Okay. Fantastic.
How'd you come to figure that out?
Hey, we were ready to pose.
Is that a gradual thing, or is that something you know? I tried it. I liked it. I kept doing it.
Do you feel
just
that you
like
were
that?
Born gay, or it was a choice?
A choice. Yeah.
So when you look at a guy, it's just doesn't attract.
It's just no attraction there. Yeah.
So and was there ever an attraction to guys? There was.
Mm-hmm.
You came to realize, or you developed a taste for women.
Yep.
Okay. All right.
I was born to a gay man, so. Well,
Salt's dad was gay.
Yeah, my dad, my real father.
There's, guess what, folks? It's the fucking 21st century. Gayness is here, and it ain't.
They're
queer.
They're here.
They're queer, and they ain't going nowhere. Okay, that's the way it is.
Hey, but I think they should get the rights that they're calling for. Just like.
Well, I agree that they should have the rights from the state. They don't really want to take part in a Christian religion. So, I mean.
Yeah, that's a big topic. Also,
but marriage is a goddamn Christian thing. But I understand how they want to get the rights from the state and all that
stuff.
And I'm all for that.
Clock. Did you just say a goddamn Christian thing?
Yes. Yes.
How sacrilegious was that?
Isn't that sacrilegious?
I went to Catholic school. How sacrilegious is that?
Yeah, they're pretty traditional.
God damn it, don't talk like that.
That's right. The goddamn nuns will...
I went to a Pentecostal church school and parents are at a redneck bar. You know?
Oh, there you go. Did you talk in tongues?
Yeah.
Now that's a party.
Jesus. Why
call me like they used to do snake charming and all that shit.
That's crazy stuff.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, I'm not that deep religiously.
All right, so I knew I noticed Mookie checking you out there, Ashley.
There you go. Go to her, her Facebook account. I'd like to see other websites. Is there any other available?
I'm working on a filthy website right
now. She has a rant.
Al and I have to put our heads together on that.
I need a couple pictures on there, so you need to...
Well, when our photographer comes in...
When our photographer comes in, be here next week. Ashley's going to get all her pictures done for her website.
I got a photographer right here.
Huh? Where's your camera at?
Right in my car.
You do? Well, there's lighting and all that. Go set it up.
There? Tonight?
Well, you know what we need to do?
I got it.
No, you guys have to take me
shopping. Get wet.
No, I need
hold on.
I need a picture of the Speedos, though.
Yeah, that's good.
I don't know if you got some tidy whiteys on
now. I can wear a mask.
Look, she's thinking about men again.
About
medic? No, she'll use
there
that picture
go.
To say,
hey,
oh,
dude.
I fucking love women.
Mark,
exactly.
Mark's going to
do
it.
Why are you worried about us? You should get her.
Mark's going to
make... Oh, she's gorgeous, too.
Mark's going to make an effort to convert you back.
If anybody can.
It's been trying.
Can.
Yeah, I'll talk you into it. You get tired and say, all right, dude.
Now, I need Rob from The Last Valorians to take me to Victoria's Secrets.
Yeah.
To go shopping for some clothes to wear.
No, Rob's not allowed in nowhere near Victoria's Secrets. He's banned.
Rob, if you're listening, come on, we're going.
Did you listen to the show or something? Oh, look, we got a listener, folks. All right. Hey, we got our first listener.
Hey, Mookie Research.
Mookie's our one subscriber.
It's a fan that seeked us out there, huh?
Actually, we had, as of today, I put it up when Sunday at 12:30, and I started tracking downloads, and they're going to give me some real subscriber information in the next couple of weeks, but we have had over 500 downloads since 12:30 on Sunday, so that's kind of cool.
Wow. Yeah,
that's
cool.
I think that's cool, so we'll see.
So it was more than just us listening
So hold
to
on now. I'm like cracking the shell here with Mookie. Mookie is joining us today. She came over to talk about helping us with some editing in our studio with some of the video projects that we have. We found out that she likes women, which is more than we needed to know, but it's something that the listeners wanted to know, and so we enjoy watching her check out Ashley Smack.
Yep.
And then we find out she's a photographer too. You ever done a shot of porn or anything like that?
No, I don't do porn.
You wanna do
okay, she won't do porn. We will do porn here in the studio. Our studio, we need to make some money.
I gotta make sure it's our company. Everybody.
We have the male actors lined up here now.
Hold up, I am married. I can only go so far.
So we find out that Mookie's
a
photographer. Next week we do have a photographer coming in. She's gonna hang out and take some professional pictures of everybody.
Yeah, we need to talk about that.
And we're going to promote
get a plan.
Michelle Lee Photography. Yeah, well, that's going to be you're wanting to coordinate so that we all look better, right?
Yeah, we got to
look.
Okay,
well then.
Okay.
You get us some makeup
for me.
Hey, it is. It
we're
is what it
down,
is.
We're dressing down. We're dressing up. We're going to go rock. We're going to go.
If she can give me a full makeup.
Yeah, we
got to
know what we're
going to
look like.
Yeah.
We
got to figure out what we're going to look like. Salt, there's no helping you. Mookie's going to start this week. She's going to go grab her camera real quick, and she can take pictures of Squig and Mark right now and knock that shit out. Mark's got his Speedo on.
Hey, Mookie.
Mark's got his Speedo on.
What did one lesbian frog say to the other?
Oh, my God.
Hey, we do taste like chicken.
What do you like to know?
Oh, I know, because I do the same thing you do.
No, not. It's been a long time, though.
Mark wished.
It's been a long time since he.
All right, well.
We still need the Aerosmith song, though.
Did we talk about the Mojo Maine deal coming up yet?
No.
I don't think we did. We need to talk about that. At Mojo Maine on Main Street in Newark, starting in October. The Foul Mouth Owl Show will be going to Mojo Maine, Main Street, Newark, and remoting our show from there. We will be bringing some entertainment, some bands, and some theme parties. I think the first week maybe we'll do pajama party, get to know everybody a little bit better. Just come on in your pajamas and hang out. And
I just sleep in my underwear.
Whatever you want to come in.
I sleep naked. I do, though.
Squiggity sleeps
next
naked.
To his dog.
Squiggy, he's going
to
have on duct tape and a sock.
He's going to wear a sock.
Can I tell you a weird story?
He's going to wear a sock and he's going to have a toga on. Squiggy, you going to wear a toga? Yeah.
He said a sock.
You going to wear a toga?
A sock.
On our show, for our show in October?
No.
He's not hung enough.
What are you going to wear? It's a pajama party.
He can wear
oh, man, I got Halo pajamas.
He can wear a
Halo
pajamas. Sumo wrestler.
What's Halo pajamas?
Halo, the video game Halo.
Oh, I gotcha. I gotcha.
Him someone of those underoos, Al.
His Halo underoos, yes.
They still make them.
Yes,
if
I believe
not, we're
so.
We're making some for the pajama party. We're coming up with some.
Well, it looks like the band's going to be here shortly.
Can I tell a story about last night?
Go ahead, hurry up.
Last night, a weird thing happened to me.
What was that?
Yeah, my dog's super scared of all kinds of thunder and lightning. So, and also, my dog's very scared of water. It's a bitch trying to get the dog to get a bath. Last night, I get home, and I take a shower. I'm sitting there showering and shit like that. And, pardon me. I'm showering and shit like that, and I close my eyes and washing my hair, and all of a sudden I felt something go between my legs.
Ew.
And I was like, hold up, it's either my wife or it's the kid, my youngest, trying to get in the shower with me. But the last thing I thought it was my dog.
That's it.
My dog's down there. So, you know. Dog's been stinking. He needed a shower. So I ended up taking a shower with my dog last night, which is kind of weird if you think about it.
Did you teabag the dog?
You know. Have you done that?
He yelled at him like an alligator.
That's great.
He yelled for Jen. He was like, Jen, get the peanut
butter. No, actually, I didn't want Jen to see me with the dog in the shower.
Oh, what were you?
So I called my oldest. I called my oldest to come and...
I can call Mikey right now and ask him.
Yeah, go ahead. And anyhow... he brought the soap, and I took a shower with my dog, and it was just kind of weird after the thought of it.
Would you guys smoke cigarettes together?
Did you make the dog scream at
but,
the bacon?
But it's like the dog did rub up against my genitalia a few times.
It was by his tongue.
And then it started
wet,
getting out. Yeah, then it started getting riled up trying to get out. So I'm wrestling this dog with my with a nut slapping against his back.
So, I can see fat ass Mike trying to ride his dog around the house.
Yeah,
come on now.
But
that was disgusting.
Looking forward to that. But
that's great.
That would have been good video.
That's disgusting.
Least, you know, I just thought it was funny because, and then I started thinking, you know, that dog needed his nails cut too. All
right.
And it got my feet a few times.
Well, you're about sick, man.
Yeah.
That's
well,
a sick
anyway.
Thing.
Did you express its anal glands?
Well, look, we're gonna take a quick break. We're going to hear a quick song, and then we'll be back here shortly, and we're going to go through this viewer mail, and we'll be back with the band My Name is Drew here shortly.
This is Alaska Golden. While you're busy sitting at home creeping on Facebook, pull up to the Foul Mouth Al Show link and tune into the show. You'll be glad you did.
He's got it perfectly timed.
With the clock ticking down, a decision to be made. I'm feeling pressure from all around. Though this feeling did not fade. Now I'm shifting into fifth gear. I'm racing toward the end. All these consequences looming. I fear this is a trend. And you asked me, are you in? And I said, after freaking lately! I said, after freaking that!
and I said, that's a freaking Thursday!
Oh, 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 oh. Whoa!